It's Tuesday, August 16th, 2011. And it's time to start my newest adventure, the 40-mile Grafton Loop Trail here in western Maine. This should be fun. I'm Tuts, and this is Trekking Along. Packing up my last few pieces of gear here. The weather has not been very good as of late, but it's supposed to clear up. In fact, there's some blue sky over there right now, so that's good. The next couple days is supposed to be gorgeous, and that's really good. Now, being a loop trail, this is going to allow me an experience I have yet to have here long distance backpacking, and that is I don't have to hitchhike. I get to finish exactly where I started from. What a concept. Got a couple new pieces of gear. This titanium pot. Hopefully that'll come in handy. It's a little bit bigger than the one I used on the New York Long Path at about 800 milliliters, 850 milliliters or so. So hopefully I can cook two things of ramen in it at once, which was the main drawback of my last pot. I'm carrying jerky, hooray, because it's not a huge long trip where that would be a waste of money. $5, I can do that for a couple days worth of jerky. And Scully. Now this little bugger, he is a plug-in microphone, so I can listen to my tunes. Excuse me, he's a plug-in speaker, so I can listen to my tunes whenever I like to and don't have to wear headphones. Now, he's rechargeable, so he doesn't last very long. Drawback for going 5-6 days at a time. But I'm only doing 2 nights. So he should last that long. Almost ready to go. All done packing. Let's go. Call it my last farewell to civilization for a couple days. Once again, this being a loop trail, it means good things for me. I don't have to worry about hitchhiking. Being a fairly short trail, 40 miles, I don't have to worry about resupplying. So I get everything I need right on my back. Trail sign. Display is blue. I think partially because it intersects with the Appalachian Trail. And actually is the Appalachian Trail for a little bit. It's in the Mahoosuc Range of the White Mountains, meaning it's going to be difficult. Uh-oh. I love people. One thing about Maine that you can't underestimate is just how lonely the wilderness is. It is a dense, dense wilderness, and well, there's very few people. And even though this is a fairly well-traveled area by hikers, it's a Tuesday,
in the late summer, and the weather has been bad leading up to now. So I got it as only one car in the parking lot, other than my own. No telling how long they've been out or which direction on this trail they went. Remember, it's a loop trail. Well, it's very possible I won't see anybody tonight at the campsite or tomorrow. I imagine, though, that tomorrow, crossing the Appalachian Trail, following it south for a few miles, probably run into a few thru-hikers. Just a guess. It is mid-August. A lot of them are probably still heading up through, so that'll be fun. Hard to make that out, but that is my first vista on the Grafton Loop Trail. It's quite beautiful. I can see it. I think that's Old Spec, third highest mountain in Maine. I'll be climbing that hopefully tomorrow if I can manage the distance. Spec's in the clouds today. Cleared up nice. It was raining all day yesterday and all day today up until about a couple hours before I left. And now the blue sky's coming out. Sun's out. It's getting quite warm and quite humid. And I'm starting to sweat. Well, I'm about 2.5 miles in. Gotta keep going. Well, I suppose this is the viewpoint near the top of Puzzle Mountain. Gorgeous viewpoint of the Mahoosics there in front of me. Out there, that's Bald Pater, what the locals call it, Saddleback Mountain. Obscured by the clouds, way over there is Old Spec, Sunday River Whitecap right in front of us. And then way over there, Grafton Notch State Park. That's where we're headed. Not tonight, though. Started way too late to get that far. I started at about 5. It's about 6:15 right now. I started late partially because of the rain. It was raining so bad most of the day that I just didn't want to leave. So, whoa, almost fell. So I decided to... I'm lost. When you're lost, it's best to retrace your steps. Okay. Found a trail again. A couple things. One, it's very slippery because of all the rain. Two, I was paying more attention to you than I was to where I was walking or what trail I was taking. And the trail, quote unquote, I was taking was not a trail. Always be careful of that. Even the best of us can get turned around. But I found one of these little buggers, a cairn down the hill, and that directed me in the right way. And now, back on the trail. Oh, low bush blueberries. Wow. Oh, so beautiful. Tart, delicious. That's what Maine's known for right there. Those wild Maine blueberries. My family is originally from this part of Maine, ancestrally, so it's kind of like I'm home. I grew up in the summers around here, but never knew that such a place, such a trail, rather, existed. Grafton Loop Trail. Much because it didn't back then. This trail's only been around for about 7 or 8 years. And it wasn't completed until about 5 years ago. Beautiful trail, though, so far. I do recall being very young, being driven up to the Appalachian Trail up in this area, high up in Grafton Notch State Park, above Screwhogger Falls, which is a really great place, by the way. Vaguely remember seeing these very hairy, long-haired hikers and thinking, cool. And my hair might be short now, but as some of you know, it hasn't always been, and it won't be for long. I guess I've become what I thought was so cool as a kid. A dirty, smelly thru-hiker. Self-fulfilling prophecy? Maybe. Let me tell you something. There are some views, no matter how many vistas you've seen in your life, that are so beautiful that you can't help but stare at for just long periods of time. And that's what I just experienced. I'm still going up Puzzle Mountain. I said I was near the top before. This mountain is surprisingly difficult. And as you can see, affords unbelievable views for so early on in the hike. And when you think about it, there's much higher country to come, and yet I'm already just surrounded by beauty. And difficult terrain, too. I got a feeling I'm in for a hard hike tomorrow. As of right now, though, I think I'm keen to stop and stare.